everybody may think now at this juncture, why CREDAI is organizing this type of property show. Even some of them I said also, when our executive went to the invite some officials, why this, at this time of point of time you're organizing. In fact, last time CREDAI Andhra Pradesh organized a state level property show, at that time also the situation was not that bright, real estate scenario in the state, particularly Hyderabad. But the way the show went off, every channel here present, every news media, print media has felt that those days, that the entire show was that their own show. Like that, they got telecasted our entire property show, 3 days property show. They have written good articles in their newspapers in a positive perspective. And that even what media says today, that particular show, last year's show, was the mother of all real estate property shows. It was so successful, about 80,000 to 1 lakh people have participated. And that has given lot of boost for the real estate industry to pick up. And thereafter, you have witnessed the growth of the real estate in Hyderabad and surrounding area. And it has given lot of positive signals across the globe and across the country also. Similarly, we have planned this, but later on that some development has come. The state has, the division has taken place. But again, we are feeling that this is the right time that the associations like CREDAI should come forward and organize the property show. See, we should tell the public, we should tell the investors across the globe what exactly is there in Hyderabad and why they should invest. The best thing is, because the other speakers have already dealt at length, we have the excellent infrastructure here, much better than any other metro city in India, but the prices are low. For example, in a corresponding location, Chennai, suppose is selling 5,000 rupees per square foot. Same corresponding location in Hyderabad, we are selling 3,000 rupees. So there is a difference of about 40%, but only 60% of the Chennai price we are selling in Hyderabad. So now, with that entire dilemma has gone, uncertainty has gone, the clarity has come with the division, and all the global investors are looking at Hyderabad. In fact, we already received some of the global investors. They did a lot of research on Hyderabad. They are expecting that another one more boom will come in the coming months. When we have seen the first boom earlier, this next boom, which we cannot compare with any other city, because the infrastructure is built in. We are not exploited. We are not propagated about the facilities available here. The next boom is going to be minimum. See, my expectation is if the correction takes place with Chennai, with the next 12 months, our prices will go up minimum of 50% to 100% in residential apartments. Anybody can invest blindly in Hyderabad. And this is a message I'm passing to the investors across the globe also, and within Hyderabad and AP and across the country. Your return on your investment will be a minimum 50 to 100% in coming 12 months. That is the effect, that is the signal, that is the clarity. See, in spite of all this, why government of India, when there are so many metropolitan cities, why they have chosen ITIR only Hyderabad? That shows the inherent strength of Hyderabad. Like earlier our friend said, the culture here, the climate here, cost of living, knowledge, brands here, existing global brands, and center for many sectors here. I don't want to go in detail. So that inherent strength has given that ITR, with the help of the government, Andhra Pradesh government, particularly Purnala Lakshmi Argar efforts. So the Hyderabad got it, means it has its strength. So the strength again across the country, people are looking at how to produce their end product at a lesser cost. So the answer is, the destination is Hyderabad, our brand Hyderabad. No other city can compete at the prices, and global investors, they look for the pricing. We are definitely, we are cheaper, as Ravindra Reddy detailed information has given, and other speakers also, my earlier speakers also sent, given a very positive, very good positive information on that. And similarly, see, depending on our strength, investors will come. Similarly, I have seen a strength in Simandra because of the long coastal belt because of the special package, because of the special irrigation project, because of the prestigious institutions are coming there, because of the new capital is coming. I have 14 chapters in Simandhra. They are working very well, and Simandhra, all developers across the country, developers, last 15 years every year we are visiting different countries. Our all developer friends in Telangana and Simandhra, they know what is a smart city, what is a smart capital, what is a sustainable city, how should be the infrastructure. They all know, they are well exposed. Even most of the industrialists, they are well exposed. There are a lot of officials also well exposed. I hope the new capital which is coming in Simandhra will be a model, sustainable green capital, which can be a model for the rest of the globe. I think everywhere, the Simandhra can expect a lot of investment, Telangana can expect a lot of investment because of the inherent strength. See, we all work together. We all work for the, you know, employment and creation of employment, national building. We all work at CREDAI, the CREDAI National. So these cities got, these areas got a lot of potential.